We're here in Seattle, Major League Baseball, on a Sunday afternoon. It's the Minnesota Twins taking on the Seattle Mariners. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about set, and on the hill, the big righty, George Kirby. Base runners are tough to come by with him out there, Chris.
Well, he brings into this one an excellent strikeout to walk ratio on the season, and when you consider the amount of swings and misses that he gets and the fact that he's not issuing free passes, that's going to make him more economical in his pitch count, allow him to move into the middle and deeper part of ball games. So we'll see if that remains true in this one.
1-2 now. That one way inside.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there, at least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
Here's Trevor Larnach. One down, base is empty. And that's outside.
Careful.
Hits and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, Boog, I'll tell you, when he goes to look at the video of that pitch, he's going to want to punch himself. That slider had hit me ridden all over it, and clearly he just got a little too excited and was out in front. Tell you what, when you get a pitch like that, you cannot miss it. Those have a chance to go a long way.
Two outs, base is empty. Right through there for a strike.
Looks like he's just sizing him up there. Really good pitch to hit, but he took it all the way. Sometimes guys just want to set their timing later on in the game. That may be a pitch that he turns on.
The 2-2. Got him. Strikes out the side to begin the game. What a start.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
Back at T-Mobile Park, and on the hill for the Twins, Simeon Woods Richardson. What do you look for here?
Well, coming into this game, hitters are batting under 250 against this starting pitcher, so it just shows you how effective he's been. He's been able to move his pitches around, add and subtract, change up the look so that hitters don't get too comfortable and start squaring up the baseball. We'll see what he's got in this one.
J.P. Crawford gets a chance to hit. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he got away with the mistake right there. A curveball that backed up a little bit, stayed high in the zone. You won't want to throw that one again.
Wouldn't chase that time. The wind of the pitch. And another ball.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
That one down the line. The flip to the pitcher covering. One up, one down. And now we check out the Mariners lineup. And so far this year, this has not been a very good offense.
Well, in this day and age, if you can't slug and get on base, that OPS has to be at a certain level. If you're going to produce runs, give your pitchers an opportunity as they're facing tough offenses as well.
Here's Josh Rojas. Swing and a miss. And it's 1-2.
One ball. Two strikes.
wind in the pitch. And that's in the dirt. One out, base is empty. The next pitch misses. 3-2 now.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Tapped up the first base side, Santana. He handles it himself, and the home first moving along quickly today. Two gone.
Julio Rodriguez.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the center fielder, Julio Rodriguez. Fastball in for a strike at a count 1-2.
So far, all we've seen in this at bat are fastballs. Look for him to slow it down right here ahead in the count.
And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Mariners come up empty in their first try through an inning in Seattle. No score. Back in Seattle, top of the second. And now for the Twins, Max Kepler. The wide to kick the pitch. Swings through that one out in front that time.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time he gets in the hitting zone, hard to keep the ball to it.
Got him swinging for the strikeout. And that's strikeout number 100 on the year. And here comes Carlos Correa. The pitch. Fastball for a strike.
Looks like a really good fastball today. You can hear that catcher's mitt popping. Looking forward to hearing a lot of that one in this one.
One down, base is empty. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. The pitch. Strike him out swinging. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, right now he's in cruise control, autopilot, just dominating these hitters. I mean, doesn't look like it's a fun at bat. And all of a sudden, you become in awe of this guy on the mound. Somebody's got to break this thing up. That's five straight strikeouts. Got to put a ball in play.
Two outs. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Wouldn't chase that time. Now a screamer into the outfield. Moore flashes the leather on the running catch. Down go the Twins in order. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. And we're back. Bottom of the second. Now it's the DH, Cal Raleigh. Just missed. Lifted in the air, right center field. Buxton sizing it up. He's got it. And there's one away.
Batting fifth. The first baseman.
And now for Seattle, Ty France. Ball to strike. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. The wind of the pitch. That one not close. And the count is 2-2. Rusty Valentine calling balls and strikes.
Luke, something I hear from hitters about Valentine is they know they don't have to protect off the plate too much in two strike counts, and that can be a big deal in terms of your confidence and seeing some pitches in that at bat.
And there's a base hit to left. Around first, digging for two. Now the tag at second, and he's out, trying for two.
Gotta love the hustle and the attitude there to try to stretch that single into a double, but unfortunately thrown out at second base. He was so close to being in scoring position.
Mitch Garver up to hit here. Next offering is in for a strike. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And it's a three up, three down inning. Nobody left for Seattle. We'll move to the third with no score. Back at T-Mobile Park, top half of the third inning. Here's Byron Buxton. When you examine Buxton's career trajectory, the thing that really jumps out, the speed and the defense early on. And a swing and a miss there. Out towards right center. That's well struck. Could be extra bases. And that's going to roll to the wall. And that's a leadoff double.
He was all over that one. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Jose Miranda, the next Twin up to hit at the belt and fires. And a foul ball. Man at second. And another ball.
Two balls, two strikes.
Top of the third, no score. And he grounds one back up the middle. Tosses to first. And one away in the top of the third.
Not a bad outcome in that spot. The runner moves up to third, and now they have a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. It's not a knock, but at the end of the day, it's a good at-bat.
Here's Christian Vasquez.
I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone here. Pitchers looking for a strikeout or a ground ball, hoping to keep that runner at third.
Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. And it's one and two. Slider got him for strike three.
Certainly a strikeout situation right there. The infield playing back, and this pitcher has to step up and get the swing and miss. Really nice job of attacking the hitter at the plate. Pretty big two out at bat coming up now.
This is Willie Castro. 1-1 now. Late with the swing there. Two outs. This to center field. That's a base hit as a run scores.
Well, they strike first as he gets the job done to bring home the run. These days, most outfielders play pretty deep, and I'm not sure if that was a factor there or not, but off the bat, you're thinking it's going to be a pop-out, and it just kind of nestled into that spot where no one was able to get to it. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Now at the plate, Trevor Larnach. Sliced hard but foul. Though Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs. Now this one gets away at the plate. On to France. And that will end the inning. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's now 1-0. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. And welcome back to the ballpark. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for the Mariners, Dominic Canzone. Chop to first. He'll do it himself. Leadoff hitter gone in the third.
Batting it. The left fielder.
Here's Dylan Moore. Home team down a run here in the last half of the third. Now it's belted. Deep to left. Way out of here. Home run. And this place is rocking. And this game is tied. It's 1-1.
That's exactly what this crowd wanted to see in this spot. He blasted that pitch. I gotta believe when a pitcher releases a breaking ball up out of his hand, he just hopes that it stays really high so that the hitter has no chance of swinging. Well, no luck there. That is a hard hit ball and a home run.
So it's all tied up thanks to the home run. Ryan Bliss up next for the Mariners. And another ball. Towards right center field. Touches down. That's a hit. So the one out hit turns the lineup over.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay. And now let's see if they force some action with good wheels on the bases.
Here's the Mariners leadoff man, J.P. Crawford. Here comes a pitch. And now one and two.
One ball. He's great.
Left-hand hitter waits. Ball. Man at first, one away. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Bliss. Ground second on his way to third. And they'll have runners at the corners after a one-out single.
Stringing them together. That's three hits in a row. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
And up next for Seattle, Josh Rojas. Left-hand batter waits. Slice the other way and foul.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
That's off the mark. Now 2-2.
Good spot there, but didn't get the strike at the knees and doesn't seem too convinced by the call out there on the mound as he tries to get a better sense of the umpire strike zone.
Two on, one out. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. To second, there's one. To first, not in time. Great effort there.
I promise you, they're guys that get a little bit faster when they can smell an RBI. That was a possible inning-ending double play. Great hustle, and he gets rewarded with the RBI because of it.
And now it's Julio Rodriguez. There's a strike. Swings and misses. That is the inning. But two runs for him and they jump ahead. On to inning number four. It's the Mariners 2 and the Twins 1. All set for the start of the inning. Now it's the Twins DH, Royce Lewis. And the 3-1. Foul ball there. Payoff pitch. And that one off the inside edge. You walked him.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Now batting Max Kepler. Lewis gets his lead at first. Nobody out.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Not even close there. It's 2-2. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Well, he just had no answer for that hard inside fastball right there. Just blew it by him. And not every pitcher likes working inside, especially with two strikes. They don't want to hit a batter and waste an opportunity to put him away. But if you can locate that fastball just like he did, most hitters aren't looking for it, and it becomes very difficult to get a piece of.
Now Correa up to hit. And he deals. There goes the runner. Cut on and miss. Low throw, and it can't take it out. Tying run in scoring position. Top half of inning number four. Correa with a swing and a deep drive. Left field. That's carrying well. And out of here. An absolute smash to left. It's 3-2.
When you have a team that hits home runs at such a high rate, they can get back in the ballgame so quickly. That's why that leadoff walk was extremely costly.
So one out, nobody on. And now it's the switch hitter, Carlos Santana. And another ball.
Here's something cool, Boog. When they finished building T-Mobile Park back in 1999, they actually opened it up in the middle of the season. I remember as a rookie with the Chicago White Sox, we opened the season at the Kingdom, and then when we came back later.
Oh, now this one is blasted to right. Forget it. Way back there and gone. Another one. Back-to-back homers. His 13th home run of the season, and they tack on to their lead. It's 4-2.
Another home run. This is turning into BP. Back-to-back jacks, and this club is fired up right now, Boog. I mean, this is the kind of thing where you really start to notice hitters in a lineup feeding off each other, and the collective confidence just continues to grow.
Base is empty, one away, and now the center fielder, Byron Buck, swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair, but it hooks foul. Kicks and fires. Fights that one away, still 1-2. And the righty deals. Swings through that one, it's a strikeout.
That's that classic wipeout slider below the zone right there. Just nasty. Looks like a fastball thigh high that you got to protect the zone, and then it's just that late break that fools you and kind of makes you look silly.
The pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. The pitch. And that one is lifted in the air. Canzone makes a nice running catch. But two round trippers in this inning. The long ball was working. It's now 4-2. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back in Seattle, John Chambi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Cal Raleigh. Raleigh. in the air, right center. This is mashed, way back, and gone. He's up to three home runs in the series. It's 4-3.
He just sent this stadium into a frenzy. They're going nuts. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spent on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
And now for Seattle, Ty France. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul.
Oh, just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
Next pitch way upstairs. Nobody on, nobody out. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. That one misses. Full count, 3-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Now batter, catcher, Mitch.
And the batter now, Mitch Garver. And a pitch.
Good one.
Nobody out, runner at first. Swing and a drive, deep right field. Kepler on a dead sprint, racing back, and it's gone. It just got out of here. It's their second home run of the inning, and they jump ahead in the fourth. It's 5-4. Listen to these fans.
This place is absolutely buzzing right now. You can feel the energy all the way up here in our broadcast booth. Well, Boog, I feel like we're seeing more of this these days than we ever have before. You've got high velocities on the mound. You've got stronger hitters with really good pass to the baseball. So much power in this sport. Opposite field home run. I tell you what, I feel like I see at least one every day, and that was an incredible job to keep that ball fair.
And a pitch. Got him swinging. He chased the changeup. And that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
And stepping in for the Mariners, Dylan Moore. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
And another ball.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
And he chases that one. That's the second out.
Boogie just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count up at two balls and two strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
Two outs, base is empty. Ryan Bliss up next for the Mariners.
Nothing but curveballs so far in the at-bat. Kind of makes it difficult as a hitter to know what to look for, because you start wondering if he'll keep coming with it or if they'll try to speed you up.
And a 1-2 again. In the air to left, down the line. And that lands in no man's land, a foul ball. Outside low. The count now 2-2.
Well, he might have to look for a different put-away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at-bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Gets a piece and stays alive. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And now it's filled up. Out towards right center field, on his way over, and that's the inning. But two round trippers in this inning, the long ball was working. It's now a 5-4 ball game. Major League Baseball is on the show. Ready now for the fifth inning. Christian Vasquez, the hitter. This one in the air. Settles under it. Hauls it in, and there's one away.
Up next to the Twins, the second.
And now, Willie Castro.
Castro.
One down, base is empty. And that's off the inside edge. 2-1. Activity in the bullpen. Bryce Miller getting loose out there. Saucedo warming up as well. This one in the air. Rojas settles underneath it. Makes the grab, and there's two gone.
The left fielder. Trevor.
So up next for Minnesota, Trevor Larnach. Two down, nobody on. And we're at the top of the fifth.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team. When you throw a fastball by a guy like that, I imagine it's got to feel incredible. Look for him to throw it again at some point.
Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. And that one hammered Rodriguez. Ranging back to the warning track, makes the catch. Left-hander out of the bullpen, Cody Funderburk.
And he's been hit pretty hard at times this year, so he's looking for better. Right now, giving up more than a hit per inning.
Here's the Mariners' leadoff man, J.P. Crawford.
The shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
The 2-1. And that drops in for a strike. Minnesota's bullpen with some action. Griffin Jacks, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. Ober also throwing. Lifted in the air, right center field. Kepler hauls it in, and there's one away.
Up next to Seattle, the third baseman,
Josh Rojas, up next for the Mariners. And here it comes. Swing and a miss as he chases that one darting out of the zone. And he hits a ground ball right side, gathers, and throws to first. And there are two outs.
Up next for Seattle, the center fielder, Julio Rodriguez.
Two outs, bases empty. Julio Rodriguez up next for the Mariners. Next one in the dirt. And a foul ball. And another ball. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Two down, nobody on. Down the left field line, could be extra bases. Now he'll turn for second. And he'll pull in there with a stand-up double.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of this struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
Cal Raleigh up next for the Mariners. And the pitch. And now 2-1. Man on second, two down. That misses, and that's ball three. Ty France on deck for the M's. The pitch. On the ground to third. Gets to it with a slide. Throw to first. Nicely done for the out. Mariners leave one as they hold on to a 5-4 lead. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Bryce Miller.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing out of him right here to get some critical outs.
Here's Royce Lewis.
The designated hitter, Royce Lewis.
And the right-hander deals. And he walked him.
Thank you, mate.
Well, you know this guy wants to swing it, but he's showing some good patience in this one. It's the second time he's taken ball four.
Max Kepler at the plate. The 3-1. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Walks out of the bullpen can absolutely kill your momentum. Very quickly, they're in some hot water trying to protect this lead.
First and second. No outs. Here's Carlos Correa. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Boog, not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
Roll to short, could be two. Crawford, one at second, and two. In time to first for the double play. Carlos Santana, the next twin up to hit. With the tying run at third, and we're at the top half of the sixth. Look out! And it hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Well, he's just glad that he got hit with an off-speed pitch there instead of a fastball. Man, that would have hurt a lot more if it had velocity.
And next for Minnesota, Byron Buxton. His home and away splits there. Two on, two outs. Got the back going too soon at strike two. Two outs. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Huge strikeout there.
A lot of adrenaline, we can see it right there, and sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
Now into the game, Manuel Margot. And man, they're asking a lot of him to play completely out of position. And now for Seattle, Ty France.
Here you go. The first baseman.
And a pitch. That's in there. It's a ball and two strikes.
No, he's really working that inside corner with the cutter. I tell you what, I hated that pitch. So tough to get the barrel to and to keep it fair.
Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Well, when you commit to throwing an inside fastball to your glove side across the strike zone, especially with two strikes, if you're going to miss, you want to miss off the plate in. You do not want to leave it out over the heart of the plate. So that was excellent execution on that pitch. Really tied him up, and he couldn't get a piece at all.
And now the catcher comes up to him, Mitch Garver. He had a big swing back in the fourth, a two-run homer, and that helped them get the lead.
And what a swing it was, Boog. Poetry in motion. And those are the type that you hardly feel when you connect with the baseball. Just so smooth, a great feeling off the bat.
Base is empty, one away here in the bottom of the sixth. Next offering is foul bat. Two now. And that one missing low.
Three balls, two strikes.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count.
You can see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
And now the lefty inside ball four.
Well, he earned his trip to first right there. It's not easy laying off pitches that just missed the zone like that. And it's a real discipline as well. He's put a lot of work into that aspect of his game, and it paid off right there.
Next offering in there for a strike. And the count, 1-2. And another ball. Got him. Two gone.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball, and I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location, but he found a way to just get it by him.
Digging in, Dylan Moore. He blasted one out earlier in the third.
Just a solo home run, but an important swing of the bat in this game. We've already seen him do it once. Can he do it again?
That catches the top part of the zone. It's 2-2. Struck him out, and that is the third out of the inning. One left for Seattle. They lead it 5-4. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Edward Bizzardo.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Well, one run game. Jose Miranda digs in now.
Jose Miranda.
Looking to get the tying run on base. Breaking ball in there for a strike. Moving in the bullpen, Trent Thornton preparing to come on if needed. Stanek, a hard-throwing right-hander, up as well. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Makes the catch for the out.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
And now it's Christian Vasquez. Here's a 1-1. Ripped on the ground a second to first, and Vasquez is gone.
Now that second baseman. Willie.
Back to the top of the lineup, Willie Castro, the next twin up to hit. holding on to a one-run lead here in the top half of inning number seven.
And that's outside.
And the count 2-1. And there's a ball. Trevor Larnach up next. That one finds the zone for count now.
Oh boy, that was the pitch. 3-1. You want to be really aggressive on the fastball.
And down on strikes he goes. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Nothing doing here for the Twins. Still down a run. It's 5-4. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Griffin Jacks.
And he's been really shutting down hitters from the right side of the plate this year. Not a lot of hard contact, not a lot of hits, period.
So digging in, Ryan Bliss.
The second baseman.
Righty delivers. On the ground to the left. And it finds its way through for a hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Turned on it nicely. Definitely a little out in front of the pitch, but he didn't hook around it too much and was able to keep it fair down the line.
Here's the shortstop at the plate, J.P. Crawford. This one in the air. Catcher tosses the mask, settles under it, and it's caught for the out.
The third baseman, number 4, Josh Rojas.
And up next for Seattle, Josh Rojas. Bliss, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Here's a 2-2. Got it by him for the K. Julio Rodriguez up next for the Mariners. The 2-1. And another ball. Chris with that distraction and the speedy guy at first. He's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
The 3-1. Late that time, and it's strike two.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Outside, and that is ball 4.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner in the scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
Next is the designated hitter, Cal Raleigh. First and second, 2 down. Here at the bottom of the seventh. Out towards left center. Sizes this one up. Brings it in. And that will end the inning. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth, Taylor Saucedo.
And compared to a lot of other relievers, strikeouts have not been a big weapon for him this year, so the defense should be active.
So digging in, Trevor Larnach.
The left fielder, Trevor Larnach.
The wind and the pitch. Bounce to the right side, Bliss. In plenty of time to first, and that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth.
Those plays can be tricky. They're routine, but that doesn't mean it's always going to be smooth. He delivered a good play right there.
At the plate, Royce Lewis. Trying to hold a one-run lead, and we're at the top of the eighth. Outside low, ball 2. Action in the pen down there. Andres Munoz appears to be getting ready for manager Scott Servais. The wide to kick the pitch. This one chopped on the ground, but foul. Inside, almost got him. Outside, and that is ball four.
Well, good day for the on-base percentage right there. Walk number three, and the free bags keep on coming. You down with OBP, Boo?
Here's Manuel Margot. The pitch. Ground ball could be two. Rojas.
Got him.
Toss to second. What a double play that was. Inning over. Now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Bailey Ober.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Ty France getting ready to hit.
The first baseman.
The pitch. Swing and a miss as he was late.
One and two.
That one misses in the dirt. The wind of the pitch. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Cole Sands warming up for manager Rocco Baldelli. Base is empty, one away. Here the bottom half of the eighth inning. And another ball. That one a little bit high, and a full count now. Righty to the plate. And a base hit right there. So a man aboard now with one away.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
So a man aboard. Dominic Canzone up next for the Mariners. And a swing and a miss. And there's two away.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
Dylan Moore up next for the Mariners. A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that'll do it. On the mound, the closer, Andres Munoz.
I think closer has to be one of the toughest jobs in baseball, and we see a pretty high turnover rate because of it. Every outing seems to be high pressure, this one included. We'll see if he can wrap up the win and get himself a save.
The shortstop takes a ball.
Home plate umpire is trying to tighten things up a little bit.
Swings and misses. 2-2. Kicks and deals. That's down and in. A slider missed. Carlos Santana. Next to bat for Minnesota. And a swing and a miss. And a strikeout for the first out here in the ninth.
Well, that right there is what you want to see out of your closer. Come in and close the door, cancel any hope that that opponent has in making some type of comeback in the ball game. Tell you what, that helps him settle in, and that helps everybody else relax a little bit to get these other two outs.
One down, base is empty. Fall off foul. Right-handed reliever. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Now two out.
This is definitely what a team likes to see out of their closer. Come in and just destroy all hope. First two batters, two strikeouts. See if he can strike out the side.
So they're down to their final out. Byron Buxton, the next twin up to hit. The Twins down to their final strike. Out to short. Nice grab. Gathers and throws, but no chance. That's an infield single.
One out away from this game being over, but an infield single keeps them alive. They're still breathing, and maybe this provides that last-minute spark.
Stepping in, Jose Miranda. And it's safe. It's a stolen base. Chris's wheels were the difference maker on that play. Just got in there.
Yeah, with StatCast's help, we see his top speed on this stolen base, and that's a big number. I mean, man, he really made his athleticism work for him on that one.
On the ground to short, Crawford. On the first, ball game, and the Mariners hold on to win a tight one as this one ends as a one-run ball game.
That looked like the pitcher was getting into a little trouble there, but quickly brought out a pitch that isn't what most hitters are looking for with that great velocity. But it was really good movement on the changeup and a nice win today.